Hello everyone and welcome back to another Canva tutorial. My name is Ed and today I'll be showing you how to create hard-coded subtitles for increased accessibility within your Canva videos. All it takes is some text and a few cleverly used Canva features. Let's hop into Canva and get started.
So here we are in Canva. Today we're working with this three lesser known Canva facts in less than 30 seconds video for the purpose of this tutorial. I'm going to quickly play it for you. Hello and welcome. This is three lesser known Canva facts in less than 30 seconds. Let's go. Fact 1. Smart Mockups is available to both free and pro Canva users and can be found via the Effects tab. Fact 2. You can record yourself during a presentation with our talking presentation templates. It's super simple too. Fact 3. Our audio library is full of copyright-free music, which is perfect for using in YouTube and social media videos. Did you find these facts useful? Let us know in the comments below. So, as the name in the video implies, it's a simple video running viewers through some Canva facts with a voiceover in the background. Because it's 30 seconds long and we're moving quite quick, this video might benefit from some subtitles. Now, just a little background info. A lot of platforms offer in-platform subtitles or closed captions, which are generated by AI, some other software, or are added in manually by the video composer. These kinds of subtitles and captions are usually optional to toggle on or off on your video. A good example of this is YouTube's closed captioning option. This feature isn't quite as widespread as it should be just yet though, especially across social. Thankfully, workarounds exist. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create hard-coded subtitles, which are subtitles which are built directly into your video itself. When integrated cleverly, they don't detract from your video's overall message and actually visually enhance it. With Canva, you can make them look gorgeous too. Let's assess what we're working with. Our video has relevant visuals which support each fact we're talking through, as you can see on slide 2, 3, and 4 for the relevant facts on those pages. We've also got this title page, an ending page, which are text-based anyhow and won't need subtitles. It's mostly this middle portion of our video which will require some subtitles. So first things first, let's transcript our speech in this video, or let's transcript our voiceover in this video so we have the captions or subtitles to work with. I've done so in advance by going to the notes section and adding this transcript in, and I've done this for each of our facts over here. Let's now get to the reason why you're here, adding the subtitles in. We're going to narrow down where we're going to consistently place our subtitles from slide to side. Typically, subtitles and or captions are placed towards the bottom quarter of the video, so in an area around here almost. This is a tactic used across video and film to provide the information without detracting from the middle of the screen, where the focal point of the video usually is. We're going to turn on rulers and guides and create a safe zone for us to situate our subtitles within. Thankfully, rulers are already on, it's just a matter of adding the guides in. You can do so by heading to File, then selecting Show Rulers or Show Guides if it's not enabled. Ours are enabled. So, starting from fact 1, we're going to place some markers in to establish a safe zone in this bottom quarter over here. Now, I'm not looking for any exact measurements, I just kind of want like a rough bottom quarter. I could always go halfway and then find the halfway point again, that kind of thing, but I think I'm just looking for something rough here. So I might start with maybe a 7.59, that works for me. Something that sort of intersects between these cool little decorative elements we have down there, and then probably something down here around this point. I'm happy with that. I've got this quarter set up now, and what I'm going to do is search for a square and add this in, and I'm going to adjust the dimensions of it to fit inside of this safe zone that we've created, and the color is yellow by default. I'll quickly change that to white. I might reduce the transparency of that to 80 so it's less invasive and we can actually see some in the background there. Great! So we've got this area to work with now. What I can do is I can copy and paste that across all our other slides and it would appear in the same sort of place that I have placed it on this first slide over here. We're now ready to add some text in. So I'm going to go to this first slide over here where we've established our fonts. So we've got Peace Sans and Montserrat Semi-Bold. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this for our title and I'm going to quickly align that to the left just to start with. And I'm going to start with saying fact one. And I'm going to place that, or before I place that, it might be useful for us to establish kind of like a margin. So I'll put that there and then place that here. And then I might resize this because it is quite large. I might just round this off to 60. Perfect. And we've got kind of like a purple and bluish kind of like visual aesthetic going on here, visual identity going on here. So what I'll do is I'll change this to perhaps purple, move it up just a smidge, and Again, just make sure this is aligned, perfect. And now I'm going to go back to this first slide, get our body text and paste that in. It's quite large by default as well. I might create a second margin over here just to give us some space to work with in and changing our text. Brilliant. So we've got our transcript over here. I'm going to quickly copy that. I'm going to double tap to group select it quickly and then Control C or Command C to copy and then Command V or Control V to paste. And again, this is quite large by default. Let's change this to something like 26, which should work well. Yep. And let's place it just down there. Brilliant. So this is pretty much looking how I want it to look. You can keep it like this so that the text is static. And you can do this for all the remaining slides. But for the purpose of this tutorial, I was going to animate this to show you just some of the combinations you can do here. So I quite like the typewriter effect personally. How that looks is like that. Which is a nice little touch. As you're reading, the text sort of appears and slides in like a typewriter. I'm going to lock this transparent text box and I'm going to group select our text and I'm going to start to paste them into our other slides and obviously change this to fact 2 and change the text to be the text of that particular slide. And because this text has sort of moved a little bit, what we can do just to remain consistent is to bring a guide down, put that over there, and now we have a new sort of parameter snap into. So as you can see, these two are now level. They look like they're situated in the same place. And same thing with this one. If we find that it moves, we can always snap it back to that sort of guideline there. Brilliant. And we change it to fact 3. And we're finished. Here is the finished product. Hello and welcome. This is 3 lesson on Canva Facts in less than 30 seconds. Let's go. Fact 1. Smart Mockups is available to both free and pro Canva users and can be found via the Effects tab. Fact 2. You can record yourself during a presentation with our talking presentation templates. It's super simple too. Fact 3. Our audio library is full of copyright-free music, which is perfect for using in YouTube and social media videos. Did you find these facts useful? Let us know in the comments below. While our speech cadence isn't exactly matched with the cadence that the typewriter animation is writing out our words, it's similar enough not to distract viewers. We can try a few different text animations and or even redo our voiceover to properly match the cadence of the animated text. There are ways around this. You can also just keep your text static, as mentioned earlier. Did you like this tutorial? If so, please let us know by dropping a like on this video. If you found any of the lessons here useful or had any questions at all, we'd love to hear it in the comments below, so please comment away. Catch you in the next tutorial, Ed signing off.